I'm Karen Landman. I'm an associate professor in the School of Environmental Design and Rural Development. And recently my research has involved local food systems, everything from the urban agriculture out to the rural landscape. And my most recent research is on community food hubs, particularly in the rural landscape. Yeah, the ethno-vegetable capacity is very low, I would say. The ability for people from many cultural backgrounds to find the kind of food that's familiar to them is, I think, a difficult situation right now. But it's also a wonderful opportunity to develop farmers' ability to grow these vegetables and make them available. My parents are immigrants, and when they first came to this country, they had trouble finding the foods that they were interested in. And fortunately, a fellow immigrant started a seed nursery, and he's now got his grandchildren working with him, and my parents' grandchildren are still buying from that seed nursery. So it's expanded greatly, the cultures that are coming to Canada. Toronto's a very multicultural city, and there's a wonderful opportunity not only for people to market it, but also the ability to grow these vegetables, to learn the skills in growing new vegetables in our landscape. The community food hub model is interesting in that it allows people from many different backgrounds to come together around a common topic, which is food. For example, the Stop in Toronto is a community food hub. Based on my definition, they call themselves a community food center, but they have gardens there where they grow. Each raised bed represents a different country, and they rotate the kinds of vegetables that they grow there. They have a community kitchen where they can teach people how to cook, teach young pregnant women proper nutrition, and also are able to provide food, fresh, nutritious food, to people who live in the neighborhood. So that's an opportunity for many people to come together around food who may not have a lot of other things in common. So the community food hub has that sort of potential. It also has potential in the rural areas where, for example, we have the Elmira Produce Auction. And the Mennonite farmers, who you could see is a culture apart from the traditional commodities market, are finding an opportunity to develop a cooperative and work together to produce vegetables that are then sold at an auction for clients such as University of Guelph, the large clients that are able to buy large pallets of food from them. So there's a model for urban and a model for rural. I think the way forward is exciting, full of opportunity for people who are interested in communicating their desires for the kinds of foods that they want to eat, and also for new immigrants to Canada to be able to get into farming if they have farming skills. The average age of a farmer in Ontario is mid-50s, so we need new farmers, and this is a real opportunity for new immigrants to get into farming. It can be a peri-urban situation, so they're producing for that very local urban market, and it's an opportunity at the grassroots level for NGOs to participate in assisting people who want to get into farming, and also at the provincial level for the Ministry of Agriculture to see that there is an opportunity, there's a real market, there's a real need for assistance with skills base, but also for accessibility to land. How do you find land to grow food in the peri-urban landscape where it's very expensive? So there's an opportunity for conservation authorities that own a lot of land to make it accessible to people who need to find plots, maybe only an acre big at the most. So there's a lot of partnerships that have to be made, but those are happening now, and I think that will only grow in the future. Benagan Serudo, Blake and Balogi.